like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove them all right song. My power's turned up. I'll start it right now. I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes, cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried.
Bobby
is this,
Cruz.
Is this the first interview we're doing where I finished ahead of the field?
I think it is.
It's just a pre-final, ladies and gentlemen. Just a pre-final.
Pre-final.
But, wow. Today's been one great day, I tell you that much, so far. I will tell you this. Rumor has it, I've heard it a couple times, you know, Gage is getting the speed and he was further back in the pack. So, depending on where he's going to be starting from, he's looking like he's going to be a tough force to be reckoned with today. But man, I just love this no chicane layout. Just so much speed. And, you know, if you can string together a couple of laps, it's a really fast track. So I'm just having a real good blast out here. It's awesome. I gotta thank everyone that's coming out here. Scott McClendon on camera one. I got Austin Russell on camera two. I had a little bit of help there in between the practices from Greg Dingus, Mark Schwagen, just trying to help me prepare myself. I mean, I've added the speed, I've got the driving capability, and now it's coming down to the nitty gritty. It's coming down to everything inside of me, if I want this or not. Regardless of what happens in the final, you can only hold your head high after that. Because I came from rentals. I know what it's like to be on the poor side of the racing industry, and it sucks that more people can't afford it. That win goes out, it's a pre-final win, but that win specifically goes out to all the racers out there that watch these videos, all the people that go out there that watch these videos, go out and run rental sessions and use my line to help them get faster. That pre-final win was for all of you guys.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my life.
a lot of value left in me.
That's why we usually do it over.
Doug. You okay? Get the breath. Doug.
Well, we are here with Bobby Krug in the number 51 Margay Ignite cart. He won the pre-final, started in first of the final. Very tough battle with Gage at the end there. And did you expect that move in North, or did it catch you off guard?
No, I saw it coming. I was talking to a couple people. And Gage was gonna be fast that time. I had no, you know, ifs, ands, or buts about that. But the real emotion comes from I wasn't gonna let him go by. I've been fast all day, so I didn't want it to slip away with me. Slip away like it did. There was a little bit of contact. You know, once me and Gage had our little scuffle between 2 and 3, Ryan just went, and it was awesome to see him make that move. Just after that, everyone caught us. Everyone was so fast, and there was a point where I guess Avery, I kind of pitched Avery down a little bit, and he jumped the curb and got in my rear. I didn't see him jump the curb, so all I felt was down the backstretch like I was about to get dumped, and I guess we were just hooked up, his front bumper and my rear bumper, and we got past a little bit more. I don't know where I ended up, maybe like 5th, 6th. I mean, it's still a great point stats. We've been finishing consistently this part of the season, but
it's tough, man. It's tough to go out there and have a great pre-final and qualify on pole. Very tough situation to end out here in 6th position when you're leading most of the race. So, Bobby, how do you think, I know we're jumping here ahead. Okay.
I'm sad right now, but it's just mostly because I envisioned a reality that I shouldn't have, and that's just my bad. You gotta go out every race fresh, start new, act as if it's a random draw.
Yeah.
So I don't think I was in that mindset. I just thought maybe I'd have the speed, but no, we were fast. I mean, I got nothing to complain about. Today was a great day. And like Brendan told me, Brendan gave me a little bit of advice, sent me down the side, and he said, don't do anything stupid to go for a win. And I think if I would have played it easy between 2 and 3, I could have definitely. See, I've been fighting forever to get my voice back. I was just, the emotions finally getting pulled out. Now I can talk, okay. I'm not
That's Mr. Hunter over there.
Yeah, Hunter went by me. I didn't even see the 31 go by me, but he went by me easily. Good day. It was fun to taste what it was like to win a little bit and to lead laps. Okay, I think real quick, most importantly, Margay Racing for the opportunity and for all their help today trying to get me out there to win a race. And my sponsors, Labonte Photography, What's That Like Podcast, McCain App Auto Parts, 3-2 Designs, all my family, friends for coming out here and supporting me. Yeah, just looking forward to the last 2 races of the season, and I'll soak in today, even though I'm upset right now, but I'll look back at it and think I was able to prove myself.
Well, now, I'm not Hoxha winner, I go free, oh, I'm not Hoxha winner, I go free, well, now, I'm not Hoxha winner, I go free, well, now, I'm not Hoxha winner,